Hello again, and welcome back to another one. And today we have a couple of topics to cover, from one that continues the conversation on the battle between Kendrick Lamar and Drake. A battle that was described by Jay-Z's former associate to be the most impactful battle in hip-hop history.
This has been the most impactful battle, to where it looks like the battle songs are changing the trajectory of that artist's life. It just seems like things are different for Drake right now, and I've never seen this happen before.
Damn.
And today we got more on this from Lazy Bone, and just like some hip-hop legends before him like Questlove and Ed Lover, he doesn't approve of this beef. And he broke down why he isn't a fan of this battle, and we'll get to more on this in a bit. Today we also have a story about how Eminem could have got his hands on Rihanna's RIAA Diamond Certified single written by Sia, according to Benny Blanco, that sparked some interesting exchanges on social media. Today we also have an update on Soulja Boy vs Metro Boomin and 21 Savage, and this update showed Soulja Boy fold just like J. Cole. However, he folded with a twist, as you'd see in a bit. And today we also have more that shows 50 Cent isn't gonna sit down and let Drake and Kendrick Lamar have all the fun when it comes to battles and beefs in hip-hop. We've been talking about 20v1 when it comes to Drake versus Kendrick, but 50 Cent has been doing this for decades, and even Jay-Z got caught up in the crossfire a few hours ago. And starting with 50's clash with Meek Mill, that started after 50 put Diddy Jr. on blast for releasing the diss song. Like we covered recently, Meek Mill ran to Diddy Jr.'s aid for some reason, and he was called out for this on Twitter after he went at 50 Cent. Meek, please stand down. And Meek hit back with, for what? I'm on year 15, talking the same way, making millions, feeding the family. Some of y'all need to stand up. That ish take you far, lol. Which got this response: I'm simply speaking on the exchange with King Combs and Fifth. That ish ain't have nothing to do with you. Certainly a question everyone was asking when he decided to engage with 50 Cent, because on the surface, it had nothing to do with him, unless there's something more. And Meek Mill expanded in response: what in the world makes a dude like you try to give a dude like me to stand down in anything? You look like you never chased your own dreams, bro. Dudes told me to stand down from trying to become a millionaire over a drug dealer. I don't listen to dudes at all. And this is wild, because all this waffling didn't answer the question about why he felt the need to speak for Diddy and Diddy Jr. What is the connection? And just like that, he pretty much gave credence to the rumors about his relationship with Diddy. And Meek has got users quoting 50's response to him: still chasing the dream or embracing the nightmare? And while 50 Cent has been going off on Diddy, he decided to drag Jay-Z into the mix a few hours ago when he shared this photo of Jay-Z and added the caption, Jane hibernation, he ain't coming outside till this ish with Puff blow over. No brunch, no lunch, no dinner, lol, laughing emoji. I'm all you got, I'm outside. Now, to be fair, 50 Cent isn't entirely wrong, as earlier this year, after the Diddy story made headlines, this also followed: Jay-Z's Roc Nation brunch reportedly cancelled ahead of 2024 Grammys, an event that has been happening annually since 2011. However, as we've come to expect, whenever 50 starts going at Jay-Z, it sparks split reactions, and users have fired back at 50. 50 respects nobody. Jay-Z has always been low-key on and before all of these started, and it has nothing to do with Diddy or whatever. 50 Cent is just projecting. Although some have concluded 50 be exposing MFers, he don't be giving no Fs, laughing emoji. But not gonna lie, 50 has been getting cooked by Jay and Beyonce fans, and if you were with us for the last video, you remember that Diddy's Stevie J shared a cringe video with Diddy Jr.'s 50 diss playing in the background. Well, that video has now started to inspire memes. 50 Cent shared this one a few hours ago.
Curtis! Curtis!
Rather put this shit on wax. All that gossip shit is whack. When all they had was 50 Cent. Who put this city on the map? Stop lying. Hot's been hated on by many men. And nigga, that's fine. They gon' try to stop these Eminems. And they gon' die trying. Pull up to the south side. We locked in, we got ties. Don't give a fuck about no blogs. Cause we really outside.
And just in case you thought 50 Cent forgot about Ja Rule, well, while all this was going on, after this video hit the web of Ja Rule back in the New York Knicks.
Who would I be without my Larry? Mwah.
Brother, what's that?
50 Cent wasted no time. He shared this video.
Ja Rule, no! Put the trophy down, Ja Rule. Take the Knicks shirt off. Put the trophy down, Ja Rule, and take the Knicks shirt off. Because 9 times out of 10, a Knicks fan was never him since when? Ja, listen, we love you, but listen, no, we don't know. Just step away. We don't need any type of Ja Rule luck near the Knicks. The last time you was affiliated with an NBA team, which was the Minnesota Timberwolves, they suck. 50 pulled up, took over, and them niggas just kicking ass right now. No, just step away from the program, the organization, the trophy, and take the Knicks shirt off, please. Ja Rule, no!
Damn.
And he added a caption, "Oh crap, eyes emoji. Don't bet on the Knicks to win the next game. This janky bum dude put his juju all on the team. F that, I'ma bet my money on the Wolves, lol." And he added on IG a few days later, "Man, I told y'all, don't bet on the Knicks. This janky bum dude was holding a trophy. The ish just don't feel right. Now look. Raise eyebrow emoji. I told y'all, stay away from that fool. Shake my head. Y'all don't listen." And 50 is on a streak, as over the last few days, 50 has clashed with at least half a dozen rappers. And moving on to the next point, we got to hear from Lazybone about the Drake vs Kendrick Lamar battle. And this was brought up in a recent interview on the Mikan show, and Lazybone explained his position on why he doesn't approve this battle. Check out some snippets.
"I thought we was getting into a good place. Lately, it's a lot of beef going on again. I totally don't like it because I'm a fan of both of theirs. I love Drake, man. I really admire Drake. I think his wordplay is immaculate. Whether he had friends that throwing bars or whatever the case may be, the music he put out is dope. I love Kendrick Lamar. Really love Kendrick Lamar. I would rather see them come together as a force."
Exactly.
"As opposed to tearing down. I know a lot of people say, yeah, it was built on beef and all that. Yeah, cool, fine and dandy. But I saw what that did to NWA. I'm cut from that cloth. Having that be my favorite group and then the time they spent beefing and wasting, I also got to see Eazy-E wanting to put his group back together, but he couldn't because they wasted so many times and he ended up passing away. I saw what it did to Biggie and Pac. It's divisive."
And just so you know, he suggested that perhaps boxing or MMA could be a better way to sort out hip-hop beef. And in response to his take on Twitter, some believe Drake is at fault. "I ain't gonna lie, if Drake didn't do all them antics before the beef got deep, he wouldn't have went out the way he did. It is like when you mess with the quiet kid and you didn't know they had them hands for real and they show you pepper. It is a game and we fans love it." But this only led to even more debates. Kendrick called out Drake repeatedly. Drake defended himself in the spirit of battle rap. "Don't act like Drake provoked it. He just wanted to rest after getting off tour." And yes, when it comes to the true timeline of the beef that goes back years, Kendrick is in fact the aggressor. And in my opinion, he started going off on Drake when he found out about the Ghost Riders. But what are your thoughts? And moving on, Benny Blanco was recently on the Howard Stern show, and we gotta find out something interesting about Rihanna's diamond hit, Diamonds, and how it could have ended up being an Eminem song. Check out some snippets from the show.
"Sia writes a song in under 5 minutes. It's the craziest thing I've ever seen in my entire life, okay? She was waiting for a cab. This was before Uber, and they said, it's gonna be 15 minutes. And she said, oh, well, just load up another thing. song, melody, lyrics, harmonies, everything all done before the cab comes. And she's like, yeah, that's pretty good. A lot of these artists, you have to remember, a lot of people are songwriters. So sometimes they put songs and you never know how a song's gonna feel or how it's gonna hit you. And Rihanna is such a special artist that the second her voice touches something, it's like a firework. She has so much tone and personality. When we first made the demo, I was like, yeah, this is cool. I don't know, because we wanted to give the song at the time to Kanye or Eminem. And actually, Eminem recorded a song to it, but he didn't say anything till like a year later until like it was about to come out. It was crazy.
Come on, man.
And this sparked some interesting exchanges on social media, as some were wondering, how was Eminem supposed to sing Diamonds loudly crying emoji? A take that some found irritating. Check this out. Sia would have sang the chorus and Eminem would have rapped the verses. Certainly on the aggressive side, but yep, that's how it works. And on Eminem's version, some are wondering. Eminem definitely saved his version in his archive. Maybe one day we'll see it. And moving on, a few days ago we covered the story of Soulja Boy, who went ballistic on Metro Boomin and his deceased mom due to a tweet that surfaced from 2012. And we got an update on this beef a few hours ago when Soulja Boy took the J. Cole route. He posted, "I apologize to Metro Boomin for overreacting over an old tweet. Condolences to his mom. I'm gonna seek therapy and anger management. I'm done responding to hate, new or old, 100% folded hands emoji." And before we get to the plot twist, 21 Savage was getting credit for making boss moves behind the scenes that made Soulja Boy apologize to Metro. And it didn't take long for Mr. I'm done responding to hate to get back in character, as he followed up his apology with this.
Bitches, 21, where you at? Hanging out the window. What you talking? Nah. Pussy ass, you still a bitch. Murder game. Yeah, you still a bitch. You still a pussy, nigga. I ain't apologize for you. I apologize for myself. I ain't like what I said about the mama. But yeah, 21, you still a bitch. Meek Mill, still playing in your booty hole. Y'all, Ryan Maybach truck, suck my murder game. Zone 1, Simpson Road, West Side. You talking about? Stop playing. Stop letting you in the booty, nigga. Murder game. Put a condom on next time. Zone 1. You talking about, bitch? You talking about, yeah, 21 Savage, you was a bitch slapping a knife off your forehead. You talking about murder gang. Zone 1, West Side. You want to do murder gang. Yeah, yeah, straight like that. Some y'all pussy. Bitch. Don't think it's all the way sweet. Nah, it ain't nothing. I just ain't like what I said about the. Y'all still hoes. Don't get it fucked up. You still a bitch.
That will be all for today, and I'll be looking forward to your thoughts in the comments. Thanks for watching, and see you on the next one.